Last week, I burned my hand while cooking. After that, I stubbed my little toe. And yesterday, I got stung by a bee. Basically, my entire week has been
One big pain.
but it's still a physical pain and it's quite manageable. What about emotional pain? I'm talking about hopelessness, sadness, anger, frustration, and anxiety that the situation we are in is causing us. Did you know that this emotional pain can actually manifest into a physical pain? Stress can cause pain in your neck and shoulder. Too much of worrying can cause pain in your stomach. I remember my aunt used to get acidity attack whenever she used to worry about her kids. So if pain is inevitable, what can you do about it? Simple, make friends with them. In this video, I'm going to be discussing on how you can befriend your pain so that you can get the strength to cope with it. Let's get started. Hi there, my name is Aparna. I'm a certified coach. Every week, I bring to you tips, tricks, tools, and hacks that can help you upskill your life. And if this interests you, do consider subscribing to my channel. And while you're there, do not forget to press the bell icon so you're notified every week when I post a new video. And if you're watching this on Facebook, do not forget to like and follow my page. We tend to identify with physical pain easily because we can just pinpoint to a part of our body and say that I'm hurting here. Like I have a headache or I have a pain in my shoulders or my neck. Even when we're suffering from emotional pain, we tend to give it a physical approach because we believe that physically we are hurting. However, pain caused by, say, depression or anxiety has to be treated at an emotional level. Make friends with pain so you'll never be alone, said Christopher McDougall. What he meant was that when we resist too much, when we suppress pain, it tends to hurt us more. What we fight with tends to persist some more. So how can we make friends with pain so it won't hurt us that much? When we accept the pain, the feeling that we are having, it won't hurt us that much. Therefore, acceptance becomes one of the powerful ways you can make friends with pain. So how do you accept? You can use a statement here. You can say something like, I have a knot in my stomach and I'm accepting this feeling. I have a lump in my throat and I'm accepting this feeling. It's okay. Because I am friends with this feeling. Words are really powerful. And this way of communicating with yourself that you're accepting the pain is quite magical. Your pain won't disappear, but believe me, you'll start feeling better right away. There's obviously a source from where this pain has come from, and we tend to use blame as a coping mechanism. Of them all, the worst is blaming yourself for it. We tend to have negative thoughts such as, why me? Why does it happen to me all the time? Or even something as drastic as, I deserve this. Such detrimental thoughts can amplify your pain. Learning to forgive yourself or whoever that has caused you this will help you make friends with pain. There are two ways of learning from pain. One is understanding what is this pain teaching us, because every pain teaches us a powerful lesson. It also helps you understand more about yourself at a much deeper level. By learning to understand what your pain is teaching you, you can heal yourself better and faster. A wonderful way of learning from your pain is making an entry in your journal or even writing a letter to yourself. The second way of learning from pain is to let go of the thoughts and feelings that are making it difficult to cope with. A wonderful way to do this is with mindfulness, bringing your attention to the current present moment. This helps you actively disengage any negative thought you may have. So there you are. Those are the three ways I believe you can make friends with pain. I'd like to end today with this quote. What do you think of this? Do let me know in the comment section below, or you may reach out to me in any of the social media platforms that I'm in. Thank you so very much for watching this. If you find this video resourceful, do hit a like button and share it with your friends, and I'll see you next week. Until then, take good care of yourself. Bye.